All right, everybody, we are about to go extra cray on this video because we're about to break down Kajabi versus Teachable versus Thinkific. Let's see who's going to win, that 33% chance. But first, we want to tell you a secret. Johnny, what's that secret?
We got a gift for you to help you with all of this. If you want to develop an e-learning program and do it quickly in 90 days.
In 90 days?
In 90 days or less, we have a free masterclass for you that's going to save you $10,000 or more along the way. So we got Kajabi versus Teachable versus Thinkific. We have used all three of these LMSs. When we first created our first online course, we actually used Teachable. Then, after that failed miserably,
we had to think about it, but then use Thinkific.
Yeah,
we demoed
Thinkific and Kajabi to decide which one we wanted to go with, and ultimately we did choose Kajabi. We're going to break down the pluses and minuses of all of these, starting with...
And the divisions. What divides them? The lines.
The lines divide them. But basically, all three of these are externally facing LMSs. So if you're building an e-learning program for your employees, don't use these unless you plan on selling the program as well. These are all externally facing, which means that these are for your customers. Okay? All three of these are best for you to sell your course to your customers. Now, let's break it down to another level.
Are we doing the e-learning onion right now?
The e-learning onion. The next level here. The next level here is if you are building an online course that you need to be SCORM compliant. That means that you're using Rise 360. You might be using Storyline. You might be using
Adobe Captivate.
Exactly. Then you need something that's SCORM compliant. Well, none of these three are SCORM compliant.
What?
With that being said, Thinkific is HTML compliant. So Kajabi, Teachable, not HTML5 compliant. But guess what? Thinkific is HTML5.
Right.
So it's not SCORM. HTML. It's not SCORM, but the bonus that Thinkific gets here is HTML5. It is HTML5. So it is HTML5, not SCORM. Teachable and Kajabi are not HTML5. Okay? Now, the next piece here we want to look at is the products that you can offer to your learners by using these. Okay? So Kajabi has four products. The first one is courses. The second one is coaching. The third one is community. And the fourth one is podcasts. Teachable, on the other hand, has two products for you. It has courses and it has coaching. And Thinkific has courses.
Just one?
And that's it.
Are you serious right now, bro?
So between all these, obviously Kajabi wins. It has the most stuff, but is more always better. Let's get
more
to the features.
Always better.
Let's go to the features. So let's compare Kajabi, Teachable, and Thinkific based on features.
We got to see what features they got.
The most important thing here is, think about it. You are selling your course, right, Hector? They are selling.
Selling it.
They're
trying to make that moolah DDT.
Now, in order to sell your course, you're going to need a website. Kajabi has a website.
Not just a website, but a website builder.
A website and website builder. Now, Teachable and Thinkific also have a website and a website builder.
Kajabi's better.
But Teachable and Thinkific don't have the robust landing page builder.
Landing pages.
So there's landing pages, but there's no landing page really builder. So you're kind of stuck with some templated landing pages that kind of just get created when you create the course. So you can't just make a bunch of landing pages. Okay. Kajabi also has email marketing.
Email marketing.
Now, Teachable does have email marketing, but it's really basic, like super basic email marketing. You can't do much with it. Thinkific does not have email marketing.
Yep.
No email marketing.
Mm-hmm. Which is absolutely critical to selling courses. Very, very critical. Yep. The other thing, with Kajabi. Is that just better? What?
And the last feature that's worth talking about is Kajabi has a mobile app, Teachable has a mobile app, Thinkific does not have a mobile app. No mobile app. We're really sad about it. We thought that they would, and then they didn't, and then we picked Kajabi. So when we're talking,
thank goodness we did, because we needed marketing, we need landing pages.
Exactly.
So thank goodness we did.
Remember, if you need a mobile app that is white labeled so it doesn't show the Kajabi logo or the Teachable logo, you're not going to get it here. Where you are going to get it is with Learnworlds. Check out our link below this video.
Also, we have more videos about Learnworlds.
If you are
too
interested in Kajabi, we have a 30-day free trial.
30.
Check out our link below the video.
Actually,
usually,
more than double.
Yeah, usually you're going to get 14 days. You're going to get 16 30. More days by using our link. Now, let's go to pricing. Now, pricing is important to
we're about to
look
price
at because
we got
Kajabi
the CPA
is
over here.
Kajabi is technically the most expensive of these, okay? The intro package for
intro.
Kajabi is $119 a month. If you buy it as a bulk annual price, so it's $119 times 12, that's what you're going to pay for Kajabi for the lowest level package. Now, Teachable and Thinkific actually both have a free version. Okay, mm-hmm. Which is awesome. This is something we love about Teachable and Thinkific. We love it when you can build out your courses, test them out without paying anything. That's why we give the 30-day free trial for Kajabi, because they don't have a free version, but we can give you 30 days. That's enough time to build your first course to test. But when you actually want to pay for Teachable, you're going to pay $39 a month. Same thing. It's going to be $39 over a year, so you are going to have to buy it in bulk for a year to get the $39 pricing. And then for Thinkific, it's $36 a month, and you're going to buy it for that year. So significantly less than Kajabi. So if you are really strapped for cash, maybe you can start with Teachable. We really don't recommend doing Thinkific, because unless HTML5 is something you really need, and if it is, you should probably just do Learnworlds anyway.
Go check out Learnworlds.
But with Teachable, at least this is 3 times cheaper than Kajabi. And that's why we initially picked Teachable.
Exactly.
The problem is, when you layer in everything else you need, Teachable and Thinkific both become way more expensive than this. Because even though Teachable has a basic email marketing, it's not as good as Kajabi or a MailChimp. So you are going to need multiple things. Mm-hmm. The landing page piece also starts making this more expensive. So you're going to need a landing page builder. You're going to need a better email marketing. Eventually, you can start with the basic email. That's what we're saying. You could start with Teachable if you really want to. We did. And then we realized, hey, we're going to spend a little more money and not have to deal with Zapier, because you are going to need Zapier to integrate these other apps. And people don't know this, but Zapier actually costs money for certain zaps, and you can only have so many zaps or integrations. You can only have so many until you have to start paying. So it's just way more technologies than what we want to deal with in both of these platforms. So that's why we pick one, because then we have one account and it's all together.
And out of the three, after the battle, the winner is Kajabi.
We kind of already told you that, but really, we really love Kajabi.
It's amazing.
It is the more expensive of the three, but it really is worth it. Once you start using these, it may take you a couple years to realize that Kajabi is the best, but it is, and it's worth spending a little more money for it.
And with that being said, we want you to develop your course and e-learning program in 90 days or less, and also save you tens of thousands of dollars in the process, which is why we have that free masterclass link below. Go check it out. Build your course, change your life, change your learner's life, and we'll see you on the other side. But until then,
thank you for the likes and subscribes.